morning, everyone. So it's Tuesday. I had yesterday off because my mom had to go to the hospital and Ernie was here. So I'm back. Last week I was in a weird mood because I just get like that sometimes where I just don't feel like talking to anyone or anything. Ava's here. I just got done making some tea. I also am opening up this pool one of the subscribers sent us. Thank you so much. After Ava's nap, we're going to play in this, so that'll be fun. Yeah.
Good morning, YouTube. It's Tuesday, the 15th of July. I'm on my way to work, and I'm very hopeful this morning. I guess both Chris and I have been kind of upset for part of the weekend and yesterday. But after meeting with Christina's oncologist yesterday, we're very hopeful for the new treatment plan. It's just a matter of making sure she can qualify for the clinical trial. It looks like she probably can. They ran a bunch of blood work yesterday, and they got to do an echocardiogram on Wednesday. And if all looks good, which it should, she should be in and be able to start next week. I mean, her doctor said, aside from the cancer on your liver, you're actually pretty healthy, which I thought was kind of funny. Not funny, but it's like, yeah, except for this metastatic cancer, you're healthy. Okay. Well, I guess that's good that the rest of her is functioning well, and that's probably one of the qualifications for a trial, that you're, you know, have some sort of life expectancy. So the trial itself, it's I think it could be classified as immunotherapy. It's a vaccine that's been developed and shown effective in treating ovarian cancer, and Christina's cancer is very similar in some respects to ovarian cancer. Now they're developing the vaccine for triple negative cancer, and unlike chemotherapy, which goes, you know, into your body and kills cancer cells and other healthy cells, this trial, the vaccine, what it does is kind of teaches your own immune system to attack the cancer cells. So what happens with cancer is that the cancer actually puts out these proteins that kind of trick your immune system and lull your killer T cells to sleep. So it tricks your immune system into not attacking the cancer cells. So what this trial does is it starts out with one infusion of a chemotherapy agent, which Christina's actually already had, cyclophosphamide, otherwise known as Cytoxan. And the purpose of that is to kind of take out part of your immune system, which are these messenger cells that the cancer is using to put the killer T cells to sleep. So they kind of want to take those out, which should wake up the killer T cells. Then the vaccine itself kind of teaches your immune system, the killer T cells, what to go after, and if all works as planned, and as it has worked for many people who have been using this study drug, then your own immune system starts attacking the cancer and destroying it. And some people have been able to maintain a pretty good lifestyle, and going on some for 2 years. Although, you know, this is all still very new and in developmental stages, Christina's oncologist is the principal investigator on this clinical trial here in Denver. And there's not a lot of places where you can try this treatment. So I guess we're very lucky to have this opportunity.
Look at how cute Ava's pool is. So cute. I about died blowing it up though. But we're going to do it after her nap. I'm going to let her stay up for about another hour. And is that trash? Can I have that? So yeah, she's just going to stay up another hour. What's wrong? No, this is trash. But she looks super cute today. She's got on these cute little shorts. Make her look super cute. Ava's in her cute little pool that one of the subscribers sent. I don't think she knows really what to think of it yet, but pretty cute. Can splash. Look. Look, all your bath toys I bought. So shout out to the Edge for sending this.
And the brat.
Super, super good gift, especially for the summertime. We'll definitely use it.
It totally fits on our pool.
It's perfect for our apartment. So thank you so much.
And I think Ava likes it. Ava, what are you doing in that swimming pool? What are you doing in that swimming pool? Fun?
Maybe she would like this too. Put the water. You don't have to get her all wet. You know how to pour it out? Nothing's in there. Cause it's like kinda out of the way. Like, so Ava girl and I are just outside hanging out. I had to dump the pool thing, and it like was getting on our neighbor's porch, and it was like this dramatic thing. So I finally got it cleared off and whatever, but I just got an email from someone from YouTube, and they want to send me to BeautyCon. Well, they don't want to send me, that's not the right way to put it. They want to give me VIP passes to go to BeautyCon, and I'm so upset because I think I'm gonna be out of town that day. Well, I'm like, either way, how the hell am I supposed to get to LA? So I'm really bummed because last year I tried to go, I couldn't go, and then this year I have free VIP tickets and I still can't go. So I'm like, you know. So yeah, Ava's having fun over there. Yourself. You're so cute.
No.
Yeah, so it looks like it's going to rain, so we're going to have to go inside soon. But I'm really bummed. I want to try to figure something out. We'll see. Hi, guys. So I'm taking it easy because Alyssa's here. I can, even like when Ernie's around, everyone else is around helping, like I get really motherly with Ava. But when Alyssa's here, I like feel like I can relax better. So anyways, she's taking care of Ava and I'm just resting because my blood counts are actually still low. I just got my blood counts back. My red is still low and my whites are still low. They're recovering. They're better than they were, but they're still a little low. Anyways, the clinical trial coordinator just called me. All of my counts are fine. And we're talking like, I don't know, they must have ran like 30 tests or something. And some of them were low, but they were still okay for the study, except for one count, which is my lymphocytes, which is a blood thing. And I guess my oncologist said that they, with me, they've kind of taken a beat in every chemo, but they do recover. So they're hoping they recover by Friday so I can start on Monday. So I hope so. Of course, I'm going to Google like crazy how to bring up lymphocytes in 2 days. I don't know if there's anything I can do or not, but maybe there's something I can eat or something. I mean, sometimes... you'd be surprised at information. Something you'd never think of, something like bizarre, I'll find something. And it's like, oh, if you eat this, it brings up lymphocytes. I don't know. I don't know if I'll find anything or not, but I'm going to try it. And if it works, I'll let you know. So fingers crossed with the clinical trial. If it's only one number that's keeping me from it, I will get on the clinical trial eventually, but who knows? It's going to delay the treatment. Now, the one test that came back, which was kind of a bummer, was I think I've told you guys for a few months now, I even think since April, that my tumor marker test has been around 50, holding steady at 50, which is not normal. The normal range is 30, so we knew cancer was still in there. But just by skipping the 1 week of Gemzar, and then, like, you know, just that one change. And then whenever the cancer decided to get on the go again. Anyways, it's up 20 points. It's up 20 points already. So it's gone from 50 to 70. I mean, that is how crazy aggressive this triple negative is. It's just, it's crazy.
Yeah, I just got a nice text message from my brother. He really misses Ava. I'm glad they finally got to meet each other. They got along famously. And Ava does not take to strangers or people she doesn't know very well. She's very, shy with people she doesn't know. Like, she won't want to let strangers hold her. And she'd never met my brother, but she took right to him, and it was just amazing. So... he really misses her. He sent some funny pictures he had taken while he was visiting over the weekend. And he said him and his girlfriend might try to come out again and see Ava.
It's so thick. And there was an older woman inside that was hysterical.
Yum, yum, Ava.
She was screaming, carrying on.
She just had her dinner, which she also enjoyed some soup.
Our
some noodles and some rice and some chicken.
There's a book of hers that fell behind the couch and I got to get it. Don't let me forget.
The crime scene is unspeakably gruesome. The police rule out both murder and suicide.
Daddy didn't give the ball?
I agree. But if it's not foul play, what other evil force could have incinerated Gerald Houghton?
Good girl.
Yeah.
He actually likes it when you do that, Ava.
Repairman was last seen on his way to the house for a maintenance appointment. Gleason admitted that he had scheduled an appointment.
Leading up to the attic. My mother thought that after my dad was killed...
You have fun with the scooter?
The attic had some answers, so she would not be able to.
You can show Daddy how you got on top of it today, and then she rode with it herself with her leg.
Sam Caston, who is a bit of a handyman, he's helped my dad around the house a lot. You know,
you're getting tired, honey.
Daddy put piggy jammies on you. Okay, you want to get down? So you think I think she might need a babas. You need a babas?
She's talking a lot. Where are you going? You marching around with your critters?
Yeah. Oh, that's what Dottie's wanted. Or not.
Hi, precious. Hi. Yeah, you're a smiley girl. You getting ready for bed? Yeah.
I think it's time. Say thanks for sharing my day.
Thank you.
Night, night, Ava. Daddy's gonna put you to sleep for mommy tonight, even though I usually do. Mommy not feeling too good. Alright, guys, we're gonna shut it down. I'm not feeling too good. I can feel pain in my liver and probably need some oxygen, but I'll wait till Ernie doesn't have his hands full.
Oh, you know, I get it for you.
Thanks, guys, for watching these vlogs. Sometimes I think they must be such downers, but you guys keep watching our little lives march on. So we will see you tomorrow. Bye. Hey, guys, I know we already said goodbye. But I thought maybe I would record some of what terminal cancer, or any cancer patient really, when their treatments might not be working, goes through. In my case, ever since the cancer's metastasized to my liver, I've had liver pain. It's a hard pain to describe because there's actually not nervy endings in your pain. In your liver, which I didn't know. But if cancer's metastasized there and has done damage, there's a lot of pressure that gets put on the lining of the liver, and it hurts. So for me, even though the chemo was so toxic and so horrible, and you know, the steroids were so hardcore, actually, the steroids and the chemo are very good at keeping that liver pain under control because it was keeping the tumors under control. And even though we're only 3 weeks out from my last treatment, 3 weeks as of, is today Thursday? I don't even know. I think it's going to be Thursday. Maybe not. I don't know. I don't know if today's Wednesday or Thursday, but Thursday was when I was supposed to get chemo again. But just skipping that 1 week of gems are, in my case, is not true for everyone. Like, my tumor markers have already gone up 20 points. And even though parts of my liver look better, parts of my liver didn't look so good. So just not having the chemo to control the growth has affected my pain. And I'm trying not to take steroids. Actually, my doctors don't want me taking steroids. Even though they control this liver pain. And then what else happens? And I do not know the technical term. I bet you Sherry from Canada, the retired oncology nurse, probably knows. I don't know if it's called residual pain or reference pain. But anyways, because of the pain down here in my liver, I actually get pain up here in my shoulder. But it's directly from the liver thing that's going on. So I don't know what it's called, but it hurts. And it gets you up in the middle of the night. So what I can take is some ibuprofen. But I'm having stomach problems. So if I take ibuprofen, I have to eat. And I just took Prilosec and I have to wait 30 minutes. For the Prilosec to work before I eat anything so I can take the ibuprofen so I can go back to sleep. So
I mean, this is just, this is what happens, this is what would happen if I stopped treatment. This would be like the beginning of like the downward spiral. You know, first it would start with pain and etc. And then your organs start to go. And so, you know, when you are fighting cancer actively with your treatments, you have to keep doing your treatments to avoid this pain. So I'm very anxious for hopefully my lymphocytes to go up, and really hoping I can start the beginnings of this treatment on Monday, but who knows, I might have to wait a few days after that. But the pain's very hardcore and enough to wake me up. I actually fell asleep at 9, but this really woke me up. So I just thought I would record just to share with you guys, like, this isn't what every cancer patient goes through, but you know, when you hear about cancer pain, etc., I just wanted to kind of explain it. Everyone's pain is different, and you get different types of pain at different stages for different reasons. But I was up, so I figured I'd grab the camera and share with you guys. Oh my gosh,
Ava! Ava, you're standing up by yourself on the bed.
Oh my gosh. Wow, Ava!
Look at you!
Ava, wow! Good job, Dots!
Okay, got that. Look at... Oh my gosh, Ava!